Hey guys, welcome back to Arctic Vette. My name's Trevor, and today we're going to be changing out the sway bar links on my Corvette because my driver, I think it's my passenger side one that actually completely fell apart, came out last week. And so now I finally got the time to fix it, so I'm going to show you guys how to do it.
I'm not too sure what all we need here at first, but once I get going, I'll get a little clip and let you guys know what we need. But I've got off new four for the front and back. We're going to go ahead and do them all. And I went out and bought a torque wrench because I didn't have one of those. So now I've got one of those. And when you do put these in, it looks like you're supposed to torque them down, the sway bar nuts themselves, down to 53 foot-pounds. So we're going to do that when we get around to that part.
Take your T15 Allen key, stick it right in the end there, and you get something to hold the nut and just start spinning. And this is a close-up look, so it's bolted up here and then bolted right down to there. Alright, so we got the same thing over here, but this one's still intact. It is pretty loose. I'll see if I can show you how loose it is. Hopefully you can see that. I just moved it with my fingers. I'm sure it's not supposed to do that, so I just went ahead and ordered all four. I mean, for $93 with 2-day shipping, couldn't really beat that price, so I went ahead and pulled the trigger and bought all four. Alright, now we got the front done. There's the driver's side. It's on there now. So now it's time to do the back. So we're gonna lower the front, and then we'll get the wheels back on, lower the front end, and start on the back. So let's do that real quick. Alright, so that's how you lift your Corvette. Now to do the back. Same thing back here. It's only difference is these look a lot easier to get to. So same thing, Allen key, the 5, 19 nut there, and they come off. Get them off. So go ahead and set you right there. Here you can see it. Maybe not. Finished putting in the new sway bar leaks. Sorry, I was trying to concentrate coming out of my drive. It's a pretty steep drop there, so I scrape every now and again. But this is the first time I drove the car in pretty much exactly a week. So doing a quick little test drive. See how everything feels. We're gonna hit up the gas station. And of course, it's like 10 o'clock now. And I started this at, I don't know, 6:37. But I was also trying to lower the car too. And that didn't work out too well for me. So I ended up stopping with the trying to lower it. I just couldn't get the bolts to loosen up enough. I don't think I was doing it quite right, because I know you have to put it on that support to loosen the tension, but it was just lifting the car for me instead of just that piece. So yeah, I'm not too sure about that. But overall, if you have a 19 deep socket, 19 millimeter deep socket, 19 millimeter open end wrench, an 18 millimeter open end wrench, size 5 Allen key, and what else did I have? I think that was it. You'll be able to get those stock sway bar links off and put your upgraded ones on. And let me tell you, the upgraded ones are a whole lot better than those stock plastic pieces. They actually add some weight, and I don't know. It, no more clicking and clanking when I'm driving, so. Because I did have that, and it was pretty darn annoying. So, now we're at the gas station. Looks like there's a few other people chilling here, too. So, get some gasoline and catch you guys in the next video. If you like this video, please leave me a thumbs up. If you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. Drop a comment down below. Have a great night.